everybody was dancing in the moonlight. Dancing in the moonlight, everybody's feeling warm.
My friend Sherry's here with me, and glad to have her today. We're going to get started. Here we go. The first item is something that's quite unusual, Sherry, and that is bring your feet together. And by together, I mean the feet are actually touching. They're all the way together. I'm going to step over toward the camera a little to make sure that she can see my feet, and they're together completely. Why don't you do that with me? There you go, just like that. Good. And unless you're in the military, this is very, very unusual to do. So this is going to be uncomfortable at first. Also, you can let your toes turn out like this, and my heels are still touching. So you can do this exercise at home, and that's just simply letting the feet touch in every area possible. Also let the heels touch, and that will help you a lot, because a lot of patterns begin and end with feet together, things that we're going to cover in the future. All right, item number one. Item number two is knees flexed. I'm using the term flexed because we can bend our knees, or we can flex them. Flexing means that I'm bending them until I feel the muscles, the thighs, everything start to flex. I can feel it. So it also allows me to have balance, because dancing is athletic. You're gonna be moving different directions, and flexed knees allows you to do that with more control. Now this is very counterintuitive, because although we're flexing our knees, I'm still upright through my body with good posture. And in life, if we're duck and cover, what do? Where everything goes down, right? And if we're standing tall, well, the knees are, of course, locked, and we're tall here. So I'm asking you to do two different things, quite unusual, and again, counterintuitive. I'm upright, yet I'm flexed in my knees. Now, the flex is important, and when I start to cover this, it'll make more sense. Is I don't want to be flexed knees but leaning back. I want the center of balance for me to be forward over the balls of the feet. So that's the dancing position that I'm going to dance all my dancing in. Right there, if you do that as a woman or a man, you are going to help your partner and yourself more than you'll ever know. So it's an athletic position, flexed knees, yet upright through my torso, okay, and my neck. All right, that's item two. Item number three, offset dance position. And what offset dance position is, most people already do this, and they do it because when you go out dancing, if you're not offset and you're lined up right in front of your partner, you're going to be banging their feet and stepping them. Most people already do this when you go out dancing, and you're just slightly offset, meaning my right foot is between hers, her right foot is between mine. We're going to step back a little and let the lovely camera person there, Tanya, film that a little bit. So our feet are offset. Now, they're not perfectly together right now, and that's okay, but they are offset. Good? All right, I'm going to turn around the other way. This is my director, Tanya, guided me, and now you can see we're still offset. This allows us to be in a closed dance position where our bodies are touching, as well as an open dance position where our bodies are not touching, but we're still offset. That also puts the lady more over to the right, where most of the contact is for leading, versus just a single piece of contact over here on this hand. So it's a very important thing, offset dance position. That's item number three. We good? Item number four is going to be a controlled, relaxed frame. And I use both those terms because a lot of people, and where they get the ideas isn't important, but I see them with a very rigid frame. The men especially, you men, a rigid frame, it might seem like a good idea, but it's uncomfortable to the ladies because basically you're not giving them anything but a signal to be firm and rigid themselves. And then it becomes a wrestling match. Who's stronger? And you'll see those couples out on the floor. They're also the ones that tend to have they're flying around and flinging and going everywhere. And although this is okay and you can have fun, you also can get injured. And there's a better way to dance, I promise you. So, controlled means we're going to take like a beach ball in our arms. We hold the beach ball out like this, and we're simply, as a man, I'm just going to take my left hand up and my right hand down. There's my frame. For Sherry, as a lady, she's going to do where she brings this hand up, and then this hand is going to come and lay on top of the man. But notice her frame is still her frame. She's not reaching up and trying to grab on, which a lot of ladies do. They don't know better, and I understand that. But you just lost all this contact where there's a lot of lead handy right here by putting your hand up there. We like to say, get your hands out of the cookie jar, right? You don't want to be grabbing up there. And so my frame is controlled, and I use the term relaxed. And the reason I say relaxed is I want to feel like if I was a mannequin and I don't have any muscles at all, I wouldn't be able to push or pull. But if I was a mannequin and I was on wheels and there was some way I could move, that's what she would feel. Sherry would feel me moving around as a complete unit and relax. She wouldn't be feeling me trying to do anything or guide her with my frame. Okay? So the movement that's allowing Sherry to move is my torso movement. It's not my feet, it's not my arms, it's my torso. As soon as I start to move, all of me goes in a relaxed manner. So we've got controlled, relaxed frame.
Everybody was dancing in the